In this video, we share a story about sea turtle protection in Bali. Bali Island is located in Indonesia. Bali has a unique culture. It is known as the Island of the Gods, as you can see from thousands of temples built in every corner of the island. Balinese live by their Hindu belief that abides their daily activities. Mountains and beaches are very important for Balinese. They believe in a concept that the mountain and the sea are part of Mother Nature that gives tremendous impact on life. Therefore, the sea and also creatures live within should be protected, including the sea turtle. There is a giant turtle in Balinese mythology called Benawang Nala that carries the whole world on its back. He and two dragons support the human world. If it moves, there will be earthquakes and volcanic eruptions on the earth. This sends a message that sea turtle is a valuable creature and must be protected. Indonesia is a country with the second longest coastline in the world that has a tremendous potential in terms of natural resources. Out of 7 sea turtle species, 6 of them can be found in Indonesian waters. They are green turtle, hawksbill, olive ridley, leatherback, loggerhead, and flatback. All species of sea turtle in the waters of Indonesia have been protected by the government of the Republic of Indonesia based on number 5 of 1990 on the Conservation of Natural Resources and Ecosystem Act. It is illegal to catch, injure, possess, store, transfer, or trade in protected species of animals, either alive or dead. Violation of this policy is punishable by a maximum of 5 years imprisonment and a maximum fine of 100 million rupiah. Bali is one of islands in Indonesia which is well known for its tourism and also for issue of sea turtle in the last 2 decades. Twenty years ago, Bali received a bad reputation for high number of sea turtle trade. This has become the focus of attention in the national and international scope and has created bad impact for tourism in Bali. Attention from the public regarding the issue of sea turtle trade raises various reactions, bad as well as good. For Balinese society itself, this is not something to be proud of. The strong law enforcement giving positive impact to the sea turtle protection. The management authority in Bali has been doing a lot of confiscation regarding sea turtle smuggling to Bali. It also gives a positive image to the international world that Bali, Indonesia are really concerned regarding the contraction of the sea turtles.
Hi, I'm Wayan. founder and chairman Bali Sea Turtle Society. Selamat Hari Penyu Sedunia, Happy World Sea Turtle Day.
Bali Sea Turtle Society is a society for the protection of sea turtle that is based in Bali Island, Indonesia. We work involving local community to protect the sea turtle. Since 2012, Bali Sea Turtle Society, supported by Humanist Society International Australia, running Bali Nesting Beaches Protection Program. This program including education, campaign, and sea turtle nest protection. For education program, we are visiting local community group, school, and various organizations in Bali Island to spread information regarding sea turtle protection. This activity is focused more on coastal community. At Kuta Beach, education program running during the turtle nesting season, especially on baby turtle release activity. We also are distributing turtle booklet to elementary school around Bali that located on coastal community. Our campaign program set up unique and fun. We are conducting exhibition and also interactive method using our sea turtle mascot. We also distributing a simple and cute sticker to the beach visitor. By targeting the tourists in Kuta Beach, information about sea turtle protection reached not only local and national visitors, but also international tourists.
Several locations on beaches along Bali Island have been the places for sea turtle to lay their eggs. Positive reaction was shown by community by starting activities to protect sea turtle in the nest.
Now we are in Kuta Beach. This is the one of the nesting site for the olive ridley turtles.
At the Kuta Beach, Bali Sea Turtle Society team will be on the beach during the sea turtle season for night patrol during March to October. Based on their data on Kuta Beach and surrounding beaches, so far there's only one species found, that is olive ridley turtle. Activities in the Sea Turtle Nest Protection Program focuses on data recording, including protecting the mother turtle laying eggs and also relocating the eggs into the hatchery. Bali Sea Turtle Society relocate the nest because most of the nests were located below the high tide. There is a problem with beach erosion, traffic of the tourists, animals, and minor problems from egg poacher. Bali Sea Turtle Society also record turtles stranded at Kuta Beach. During the west monsoon around December to February, the ocean current will bring a lot of rubbish to Kuta Beach. Sometimes we found also sea turtles stranded, mostly very weak or dead. The recorded data show number of turtle nests that were found and rescued by Bali Sea Turtle Society has been increasing. The first nest recorded was on year 2000, where there were relocated only one nest. In 2019, before the pandemic, they rescued more than 600 nests. And in this year, during the pandemic, so far, they have rescued more than 100 nests. Education and campaign program gives positive impact, which is shown by more participation in baby turtle release from local people and public who visited the beach.
Okay. Halo semuanya, halo everybody. Nama saya Gong Haji. My name is Gong Haji. Panggilannya Mr. Turtle. Selamat Hari Penyu Sedunia. Baik, saya akan cerita mengenai penyelamatan penyu Pantai Kuta. Saya warga Desa Dakuta yang selalu berada di pantai kota. Kurang lebih 20 tahun yang lalu, ya, kita bergerak kepedulian penyelamatan penyu yang naik bertelur di kawasan Pantai Kuta. Setelah kita bergerak tahun demi tahun, akhirnya populasi penyu makin bertambah. Nah, di mana gerakan kita untuk penyelamat lingkungan yang paling kita lakukan adalah bagaimana kita bisa memberikan suatu edukasi, ya, edukasi tentang bagaimana pentingnya penyelamatan lingkungan. Nah, setelah berjalan edukasi itu, akhirnya masyarakat, baik anak-anak muda, ya, mereka sudah ikut peduli tentang apa yang kita sudah lakukan dari awal mengenai penyelamatan satwa penyu di kawasan Pantai Kuta. Setelah kita jalankan dengan keikhlasan dan ketulusan, akhirnya ini menjadi manfaat besar bagi kehidupan masyarakat, karena pengaruhnya besar sekali terhadap pariwisata kita. Akhirnya dengan adanya komitmen kita dengan penyelamatan penyu-penyu bertelur, kita save penyu yang datang sampai akhirnya menetas, kita kembalikan ke alamnya kembali, itu menjadi salah satu daya tarik wisata. Semoga apa yang kita lakukan ini tidak putus, berkesinambungan terus untuk anak cucu kita. Semoga, kita harapkan juga lebih banyak nanti penyu-penyu di laut. We want more sea turtle in the ocean. Mungkin begitu harapan kita, ya, bagaimanapun tetap hambatan-hambatan, ya, hambatan-hambatan pasti itu ada. Namun dengan ketulusan, dengan keikhlasan apa yang kita lakukan tentang penyelamatan save the sea turtle di Kuta, ini menjadi momentum kita, ya, menjadi tantangan buat kita juga ke depannya nanti, ya. Tetap kita semangat walaupun dengan situasi kondisi dunia, apalagi, ya, Bali daerah pariwisata yang masih suasana COVID, tapi kita di sini, ya, bersama rekan-rekan tetap semangat, tetap ada spirit untuk nature. Kita tetap penyelamatan berjalan terus, tidak ada henti-hentinya, ya, tidak akan lemah dengan adanya COVID ini untuk penyelamatan penyu. Mari kita berdoa semoga semua makhluk hidup berbahagia. Pesan kita kepada seluruh anak-anak muda di dunia, ya, khususnya, ya, Bali dan Kuta, mari kita sama-sama jaga, mari kita sama-sama lestarikan, jaga penyu untuk betul-betul tidak akan punah. Bagaimanapun ini tanggung jawab kita. Ya, saya terus terang aja sudah usia ini, ya, tapi semangat harus tetap muda. Ya, apalagi yang masih usianya muda, mari kita bersama-sama untuk menjaga lingkungan. Mari kita saling bahu-membahu untuk menyelamatkan sea turtle yang bertelur di seluruh kawasan dimanapun.
How many? Who knows? In the 1,000?
1,000. The main challenge is encouraging the young generation to join the program on the field. Regeneration is an issue. This year, local community at Kuta already established a group named Kuta Beach Sea Turtle Conservation Center.
Nama saya Igusti Ngurah Agung. sebagai ketua Kuta Beach Sea Turtle Conservation Center. KBSTCC ini dinaungi di bawah dari Desa Adat Kuta. Saya di sini sejak kecil, dari tahun 2000 saya sudah di sini dan mengikuti ayah saya. Awal mula ayah saya di sini pertama sebagai ketua Satgas Pantai Kuta. Yang saya tahu, saya sudah diajak dari kecil di sini dan ikut patroli di sekitar areal pantai untuk merescue telur penyu dan direlokasi di tempat yang lebih aman. Menjaga penyu itu biar tidak diganggu oleh pengunjung. Kalau sudah penyu itu mulai bertelur dan telurnya itu direscue dan direlokasi di tempat ini. Sebelumnya sih tidak seperti ini. Sebelumnya itu ya sederhana lah. Seingat saya, pertama kali sarang penyu itu tidak di sini, tapi di awalnya penyu itu bertelur dan dikasih tanda seperti keranjang lah, dikasih tanda bahwa di sini ada telur penyu. Saya sekarang penerus beliau karena cita-cita beliau biar ada penerus untuk generasi muda. Sebelum pandemi kita di sini pariwisata pasti tamu domestik maupun luar negeri itu pasti berkunjung ke sini. Apalagi ada pelepasan anak penyu itu, wow, pasti gila, pasti ramai banget. Dan sekarang masa pandemi ini situasinya sih pasti sepi ya. Kalau sekarang sih pandemi ini penyunya lebih bebas untuk bertelur ya, tidak ada gangguan sama sekali. Tapi di masa pandemi ini Pantai Kuta lagi diambang abrasi dan sekarang penyu bertelur sudah mulai masih sedikit bertelur dari tahun-tahun lalu. Kalau dampak negatifnya pasti ada karena jumlah volunteer kita berkurang karena mereka kebanyakan pulang kampung dan tidak ada pekerjaan. Dampak positif pasti ada. Kita tidak terganggu untuk merescue telur penyu dari tahun yang lalu. Peran masyarakat di sini sangat membantu dan mereka sudah banyak mengerti tentang penyu. Di sini kita ingin mengedukasi lebih banyak lagi masyarakat, utamanya di Kuta, supaya mengerti apa itu penyu. Oke, pesan-pesan saya untuk generasi muda, ikutilah jejak saya. Ikhlas untuk melindungi penyu agar populasi penyu tidak punah.